when it comes to traditional, she had kept the same barfi, which we all Sindhis love eating. She had also kept majun. She had also made dry fruit halwa. Wherever there are Sindhis, there's a lot of dry fruit. And she had also made this new modern dish, at least new for me. Hi guys. Hi Maa. Ki aayo tama sabhi. So basically, my followers sent me this reel. I had no clue that my poster was printed and it was put up in Novotel Ahmedabad. I was clueless. And when they sent me this reel, I was like, okay, what's going on? So Jyoti Mulchandani, the woman who sent us the Osan video for the partition special series, very kindly, because she's very camera shy and she faced the camera for us. So I feel supremely grateful. So I messaged her. I'm like, Jyoti Di, what is going on? Can you please tell me who is doing this? What's happening? I also was forwarded their newspaper advertisement by my friends. So I sent her that too. And I'm like, Sindhi Khado Food Festival, can you tell me what's going on? So she said, my husband has curated this in collaboration with Novotel. And I was like, oh my God, this is such a big deal. Because anyway, I was going to go to Ahmedabad on 24th for a very, very short period of time for my work. I spoke to her husband and he very kindly invited us for the dinner, and that's what happened. I was hosted by Anil Mulchandani sir to have dinner at Dado Sutho Sindhi Food Festival in collaboration with Hotel Novotel in Ahmedabad. Oh my God, I mean, I just realized the power of, you know, what's meant to be is going to happen no matter what you do. And everything was so rush. I had to plan the trip very last minute because this event had to be included, and eventually it worked out all well. But now I want to tell you more details. I last went to Ahmedabad 22 years ago. My mother's relatives live in Ahmedabad and Rajkot, a lot of them. So 22 years ago for my cousin sister's wedding, I had gone to Ahmedabad, and now after 22 years, I went back to the city and I loved the city. It's like I could feel how beautiful and peaceful the city was. Like, the roads were huge and it was very airy, less humid than Bombay, definitely. By now, you guys already know how much I love Sindhi food, how much I believe in the power of cultural foods. You have seen me make videos with other Sindhi chefs, Jyoti Di, Mohit. I personally have cooked so many dishes and made videos on this channel. My brother, you've seen him cook Sindhi food. Basically, the amount of satiety that we get from our cultural foods, no other foods can give us that. And research has proved that. Anyway, moving on. I knew that when I would reach Novotel Hotel Ahmedabad, I had requested Anil sir to please come in, and I also wanted to meet the chef. So I had called her one day prior and I was very clear that I wanted to make dedicated videos with them. I wanted to know how the festival happened and how did the chef come up with different dishes and what was she cooking, and behind the scenes. Basically, behind the scenes interests me a lot. So I shot separate videos with Anil sir and Soni Di, the chef, Anil sir, the curator, Anil Mulchandani. So you're going to watch their videos soon on this channel. Stay tuned for that. Obviously, I was very excited to see my poster, and as soon as I entered Hotel Novotel that evening, I was like, oh my God, let's just have a look at what's happening. As soon as I entered, there were these huge posters announcing the food festival and talking more about Sindhi culture, and there I could see a huge poster on Sindhi music. And on the right hand side, like as soon as I entered, there was a poster of me, and there were other posters of Motilal Jotwani, Ram Jethmalani, LK Advani, SP Hinduja. And I was like, oh my God, I am placed amongst these huge, you know, like stalwarts of Sindhi community. And I was feeling so honored. I was like, oh my God. And the staff there also told me that Dia Madam had first thought that she'll put the poster just below the TV so that, you know, people can have a quick look at it, but then they changed their mind and she wanted people to first look at my poster. So she placed my poster right at the beginning, like as soon as you enter, on the right there was my poster. I'm fumbling. There was my poster, and I was like, oh my God, such a huge moment. And it like it definitely shows that it was very well researched, not just because they included me, but because there were posters of different people from Sindhi community. So they had touched upon Sindhi culture, Sindhi music, Sindhi YouTubers, and you know, people from the politics and people from Bollywood. And I was like, okay, I want to meet these people. And before I went, I had asked Jyoti Di that who have done the research and the printing of everything. And she said it's her brother and sister-in-law, and they are event managers. And I was like, okay. So it definitely showed that there was a lot of good research that had gone behind this. Also, Jyoti Di informed me that they had consulted Murli Bhojwani Dada. So I'm very grateful to you too, Dada, the one who lives in Baroda. So I was very touched, and I was feeling like, oh my God, I want to meet these people. But Jyoti Di had informed me that they were busy due to work, so they couldn't come. They had other events to go to. But just look at my stars. Just when I was about to leave the hotel with my team at about 11:30, 11:45, it got quite late. And the dining was closed by 11 p.m. We were still shooting. Diya Didi and Narendra Bhaiya, the husband and wife duo who did the event management, they came in to check in with their staff. You know, they were taking off the posters, their staff, because the festival was over and I had gone on the last day. So I was like, oh my God, she came up to me and we spoke, and I really wanted to bring her in front of the camera, but they're super shy, both of them. I'm very grateful that I got a picture in with them. But I was like really impressed with their hard work and their presentation and just everything, you know. I read up all the posters. There were no grammatical errors. You know, I'm a little bit of grammar Nazi. So I was very impressed with the whole thing. They had covered people from different fields of Sindhi culture, and they had included me too. I used to think that I'm the queen of research, you know, when it comes to Sindhi culture, and you know, I know everything. But I was super impressed to see that they had done such a fab job with everything. And just in general, it just made me very happy to see how very neat everything was, how very planned out everything was, you know, and placed strategically, printed out strategically, well presented basically. And I'm sure it must have costed a lot, but that just shows how much hotel Novotel as a hotel and Anil sir and Diya Didi have put in the effort to make sure that it's not just about the food, but to make their guests aware, make non-Sindhis aware of what the culture is, what the food is. I was very happy with everything. Congratulations, Anil sir, Novotel, Sony Di, Diya Di, Narendra sir, Jyoti Di, to all of you guys. I mean, for a 5-star hotel to have these beautiful posters in their dining area so that guests can see is a huge step. So I want to congratulate Hotel Novotel to join hands with Anil sir, Chef Sony, and to curate this beautiful food festival. It just really felt like, you know, we are back to pre-COVID times. I got to step out, I got to travel, and it was such a fun trip. I truly enjoyed every minute of it. You know, the social interactions, I had truly missed seeing people, meeting people, sitting and having meals with people. So yeah, it was a really lovely evening. Now I've talked about the interior, I want to move on to the food. It was very interesting when Sony Di told me that she had cooked up a storm. All days of the festival, she had made sure that the menu had something new in it. She had cooked different dishes every day. And I was like, wow, that's fabulous. And yesterday when I was talking to Bhairavi, the social media manager of Novotel, she told me that they usually have guests who stay for a longer period of time. So for those guests, if the dinner package is included, if their packages include dinner, the food should not be repetitive. So, you know, all of these thoughts had gone behind making this menu, to curate this menu. And I just feel like they did a fabulous job. I am now going to show you clips where Sony Di is walking me through the food that she had cooked. So there was dal pakwan, there was kachalu, my favorite, all-time favorite. But in the desserts, there was a mix of a little bit of traditional and a little bit of modern. So when it comes to traditional, she had kept the sev barfi, which we all Sindhis love eating. She had also kept majun. She had also made dry fruit halwa. Wherever there are Sindhis, there's a lot of dry fruit. And she had also made this new modern dish, at least new for me, orange rice kheer. I've never had that before. So it was a new thing for me and it was yum. I have to tell you. I haven't included clips of me eating because you've seen me do that many times. The point was not about me eating the food. The point was me getting to experience this festival that they had beautifully organized and curated. Firstly, like I've said before, I believe in the power of cultural foods. No other foods can give us the satiety that comes from these foods. That A. B. COVID really affected a lot of industries, especially the hospitality industry. And it was good to see that, you know, slowly things are getting better. It genuinely felt like pre-COVID times. And you've seen in one of my previous videos where I've talked about how the two most populated cities, Sindhi populated cities in India are Ulasnagar A and B, Ahmedabad. So it was nice to see that Ahmedabad had hosted this event focusing on Sindhi food and Sindhi culture. And, you know, the Sindhi community was given a chance to showcase their food and their culture in collaboration with the hotel. So super proud of you, Anil sir. But also it felt really nice to see my culture and food on display, and I got to travel and experience the whole thing. It truly was about the experience. It felt amazing. I clicked pictures with my posters, and what a beautiful surprise. I mean, I feel that is a real test of your efforts and hard work when people talk about you or when people put up your posters without asking you or without telling you. You know, you feel like, okay, you've achieved something, just a little bit. I'm not tooting my own horn, but I am a little bit. And I genuinely feel it is an absolute honor to get to work for my mother tongue day in and day out. I mean, the amount of efforts that go behind making this one video, only my team and I know, but I'm very glad that I still get to do what I want to do. It wouldn't have been possible without your love and support. So please do share this video, subscribe to the channel, do like the video. And if there are any Sindhi events that you would like me to attend, please do email me, comment below, get in touch with us on Instagram. It would be an absolute honor to get to attend and vlog everything. Once again, a huge congratulations to Anil Mulchandani sir, Hotel Novotel, Chef Sony, Jyoti Mulchandani di, Diya, Narendra Bhaiya. I mean, all of you guys who put up such a fabulous show. I mean, keep it up. I was mind blown. Honestly, can't wait to see you guys do this more in different cities. And I hope to be there with you all celebrating every milestone. Keep it up. I am hoping many more such events happen. And, you know, we as a Sindhi community get together and rise to the occasion. Because Sindhi language is already on a deathbed. So I'm hoping that things get better now. And I think there's a lot of hope with Sindhi food and Sindhi dances and Sindhi cultural events happening. I think we still have hope to save the language and the culture. See you in the next video. We are very active on Instagram. Please come and say hi there. Like this video, subscribe to the channel. And until next time, bye-bye.